I fished this since I was 13 when I had my first boat. I just used to run down from school, just make the tide, cut steam out the arbour. Then I get my mum ringing me up, going, you shouldn't be out there, it's scary. All fun though. First I wanted to be a football player, then it was a porn star, but I had to set my hopes straight. Just love being on the sea, driving a boat, whatever.
Throwing my own boat at 18 is a pretty amazing thing, but at times it can be very stressful. It's a lot of responsibility because I'm looking after everyone, I'm looking after the crew. I'm trying to catch the fish as well, keeping your eye on the weather. To pay off the loan, I've got to keep the boat working every day.
I got Jack Smith on, he's my sister's boyfriend. He's the chief bait cutter upper. I got my dad with me because he thinks he's still a fisherman. Pull dad out of bed like endless occasions. To be honest, we just come out here and just take the mick out of each other. Kettle's boiled.
Kettle's boiled, Jack, kettle's boiled.
Doesn't mean you're getting anything. Too small. Yeah, measuring them just under, or in, but rather put it back. May have kids, grow a bit bigger. I don't see any reason to keep them. You're just messing with your own future, to be honest. Yeah, start early, because then you've got enough time to get back into the arbour, wash down, then swap over to chartering, so that's when I get my other crew jacked down.
Always get the breakfast, yeah. Ben normally gives me the money. If not, just take it off him.
I bought Silver Spirit because I had the dual commercial licence. So I got a fishing licence so I can sell my fish commercially. I've also got a passenger licence. So nice to have that flexibility.
Good afternoon everyone. I'm Ben, that's Jack. One speed, whatever you like to call him, he answers to anything.
You ever done it before, my love?
No.
Right, simple. If I can do it, one speed can do it, you can definitely do it.
And this switch here is your brake. You turn that off, the light can go out. And when you get a whopper on and you have to hold your leg down, all it is to wind it clockwise.
Come on, fish, 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 fish. Come on, fish, 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 fish. Summer season's really important. Could be anywhere between 4 and 5 charters maybe a day.
Could be working from 8 o'clock in the morning to 8 o'clock at night. And on a Thursday night, it's lifeboat training. I try and make that as much as I can. If there's a shout and I'm around, I will run for it. It's the only time I do probably ever run. Lifeboat's very important to me. I've grown up with it my whole life. My dad's the volunteer coxswain, and me and Jack have been fundraisers since we were 13. I'm a crew member on the inshore lifeboat and the new Shannon class all-weather lifeboat. So we never know what we're going to be doing when we go out and exercise. They've just chucked two fenders over as a man overboard. So they're sending me out into the spray rail. We've got to connect our lifeline with the right length so our hands are free so we can lean back far enough to grab the casualties. Even if it's been a long day and there's fish to be had, I just grab a bunch of mates. I grab the boys off the quay who've been booking up for me all day or crewing on other boats, and we'll come out here, have a laugh. We'll try for some bass. I've got Jack, Ben, Paul, Dom and Sam. The bass will be hiding around the back waiting for any of the bait fish to come over the top. Rod and line in is really sustainable. If it's too small, you can send them back. I had a bite. We're drifting really fast. I mean, we're drifting it like 2.7 knots and you get such a little time fishing. Get them up, boys. Some days you'll catch stringfuls of bass. Sell them on to the restaurants. And other days you'll just catch nothing. I mean, it's called fishing, not catching, for a reason. You gotta be in it to win it. Let's get in it. I love coming out here, like, with my mates. I don't drink or anything, so this is kind of my night out. It's the best thing ever. You got your own commercial fishing boat. You can't knock it for the world, really. So after the charter season finishes, I'm on bass fishing up till Christmas. Then the boat comes out, then I try and jump on one of the local potting boats. If that doesn't work out, I have to get a proper job.
I just want to be out on the water every day, every hour.